We expect you to obey these rules, and I will be here to enforce them. In the event of a knockdown, you must take an eight count. The three knockdown rule has been waived. Break when I tell you to break. Shake hands now. Come out boxing. Good luck to both of you.
They're wearing 8-ounce gloves. The heavyweight championship of the world, if it goes the limit, they use a 10-point must-scoring system. The winner of a round gets 10 points. The loser gets 9 or less. An even round, they both get 10. Joe Frazier, 214 pounds, 8.5 pounds heavier than when he fought Muhammad Ali. It's scheduled for 15 rounds here in Jamaica. Frazier, the white trunks, Foreman, the red trunks. Frazier boring in. Frazier rarely wins the first round. I'd be surprised if he won it now. Foreman a little bit tense looking. Foreman has been nailed and nailed good. Joe Frazier's best punch is his left hook. Foreman apparently not trying to keep Frazier off with that jab. Now Foreman looks a little looser. That was a tired left hook that caught Frazier. Arthur McCandy, the referee, goes between them. Foreman showing a good, smart, snappy jab and a good uppercut. Foreman having a very good round. Show is down. Frazier went down. Taking the mandatory eight count. A minute to go in the round. Frazier's in real trouble here. Frazier seems to be hurt. He's being rocked. Foreman in complete charge of the fight. Frazier fighting back gamely, but he's having trouble. There's the countdown, 20 seconds to go. Taking the mandatory eight count. The round is almost over. Foreman after him again. Frazier has never taken this kind of punishment. And it goes down at the bell. Arthur McCandy rules that he's taking the mandatory eight count at the bell, but he's up. Frazier was down three times. Yancy Durham is holding him there. Let's see the first knockdown. That almost looked like a glancing blow, but down Joe went. He took the mandatory eight count. The referee, Arthur McCandy, is looking at the corner of Joe Frazier, looking at Joe. Here's the knockdown at the end. Frazier just sags down. Ric Flair of the knockdown. George was going to belt him again, but thought better of it. Here's round two. Foreman Foreman in complete charge. Up to now, Frazier and Powlett. Foreman is being warned. Frazier is being battered in Foreman's corner. Joe's about to go down. He does. He goes down again. Joe is desperately trying to get to his feet. He's on his feet. He's taking the mandatory H-count. 45 seconds to go in the round. Joe's been down four times. Foreman at him again. It's hard to see how Frazier can last. Joe is down for the sixth time. Let's see if the referee stops it. No. He's trying to get his man to a neutral corner. Frazier doesn't know where he is. The fight is over.
Center of the ring. What do you think about Muhammad Ali when you're in there like this?
Well, right now, you know, you're a little nervous. You're a little shaky in the knees. And, but it's a funny thing. After the, I guess ball players experience the same thing. After the bell rang and you come out and the first punch is thrown, then it's just like another day in the gymnasium.
There it is from a man who certainly knows.
George Foreman and I have just been offered $5 million apiece, which is unbelievable, by the government of Zaire. Which is used to be known as the Belgium Congo in Africa. And if he can win this fight tonight, which I don't think he will, if he win the fight, he and I will defend, he'll have to defend his champion again in the Congo.
Well, that's certainly your territory, Ali, but right now, talking about this fight, look at the concentration and the stare job that Foreman is putting on Ken Norton. Norton certainly has plenty of confidence in his own right. Norton on the right-hand side of the screen, George Foreman on the left-hand side. Here we go, round one. The heavyweight championship of the world is at stake. Let's watch and see if Foreman comes on strong. To this point, Norton has thrown the only punch. A light left on, taken on the gloves by George Foreman. Wild left hand over the head of George Foreman. Both fighters exactly the same size. Foreman slightly heavier, about 7 or 8 pounds heavier. Norton and Foreman both 6'3". On the right-hand side of your screen is the champion, Foreman. On the left-hand side is Ken Norton. Norton in blue, Foreman in red. Round one just underway in Caracas, Venezuela. Foreman showing the concentration. Foreman looks a little bit more patient than we've seen him. He knows he's got a fight cut out for him because he's in against a real big fella. Foreman goes out with that light left taken on the shoulder by Ken Norton. Is the pushing tactics. Foreman starting rather slow, feeling Norton out. Norton, that won't call it a classic style, but certainly the style of dragging that right foot behind him. Vicious left hook goes over the head of the champion.
Boxing, Jimmy.
Pretty good straight left hand thrown by Foreman, taken on the face and a right hand to the kidney. That's a punch you've got to watch out. There's a good left hand, the best right that we've seen. Foreman pushes down on the head of Norton and landed a right hand, straight left hand to the face of Ken Norton. Norton trying to jab more with his left hand. This is what they say he has to do. Kind of a fishing left hand thrown by the champion. Right hand to the kidney thrown by the champ. Both fighters, the best punch is their left hook. There's the right hand again to the kidney of Kenny Norton. Norton takes a light left, throws a right of his own. 1 minute remaining in round one. Very even first round at this point. Light left hand taken, wild right hand, another left hand taken on the gloves by Norton. Norton scores with a left hand to the side of Foreman's head. Left hand miss, and left jab in the face of Foreman. Light left on the forehead. Pretty good left hand on the forehead of Ken Norton. Norton with put his back up against the ropes. This is where he can't afford to stay. Slips the punch and slides around to his left. Very important type of movement. Norton hanging on with that left hand and tries to throw that wild right hand to the body. Foreman is not a great boxer. He's a great puncher, though. Norton is a good boxer. As Foreman comes in and tries to hold up, Norton backs up. 9 seconds remaining in this round, the first round. Foreman kind of feeling out Norton. There we go, the opening round of the heavyweight championship of the world in Caracas is history. Muhammad, what did you think of the first round?
Just like I thought it would be, Ken and Norton boxing. George Foreman not throwing all those hard punches and punching them out easy like he did Joe Frazier, because Ken and Norton's a great fighter. Any man who goes 12 rounds, 24 rounds with me, it's got to be great. And ain't no George Foreman, who's still a good amateur, going to destroy Ken Norton, because I couldn't do it. And I'm proud of what Norton did, because it shows the world that Norton is a great fighter.
That's George Foreman we're watching. He hardly looks like he's built up a sweat yet. That's Archie Moore working on him, his handler, Dick Sadler. Coming up to round two, first round very even. Maybe a slight edge on the amount of leather landed on Norton would have to give to George Foreman. Muhammad Ali is continually yelling instructions to Ken Norton. This is Norton's corner here now. Norton filled with concentration. He's a positive thinker. In fact, he won the Napoleon Hill Award for Positive Thinking, a foundation award. Here we go, round two, the heavyweight championship, Caracas, Venezuela. George Foreman, Ken Norton on your left. Now watch Foreman try to cut off Norton in the corners, but Norton is working the left jab much better as he slips a punch and out of that corner. This is what Norton must do. Norton tries to jab. Foreman holds those hands up and tries to push. No damage done there. Foreman pushed that away. Foreman will try to push and he'll push his man down with his left hand and then throw the right. Foreman, see him trying to cut Norton off on the corners. Kenny Norton has got plenty of boxing experience. 24 rounds with Ali is a master's degree in boxing in any man's school. This is what he can't do. He can't mix it up with Foreman inside. Referee Jimmy Rondo separates the fighters. First real clinch of the fight. Round two, scheduled for 15, the heavyweight championship of the world. Oh, good right hand on the left-hand side of the face of Norton. Norton is a bit stunned as Foreman is teeing off. And it looks like Norton has really been staggered as he went up against the rope. The referee is giving it the count. Yes, he'll have to take the eight count. Okay, 7-8, and here we go as Foreman comes banging on in the second round. Norton goes down again. A left hand on the side of the head. Norton goes back. He'll have to take another eight count. No, he doesn't. His legs are rubbery as a left hand goes to the side of his head. A right uppercut, a left jab, and a vicious left sends Norton crumbling to the canvas for the second time. Norton is in Queersville. He doesn't know where he is. It's up to 5, 6. I don't know if Norton can make it. It might be all over right here. It's up to 9, 10, and are they going to continue it, or are they going to stop it? It looks like it may be all over, and it is all over. George Foreman. Second round knockout. Nobody really believed that this fight would go out in two. Here we go. Watch that. There's the left. Then look at that right uppercut. Tremendous right uppercut. Now here he comes on. Another vicious right hand. And that's the one that did the damage. That left hand put him out to stay. Now watch this one. There's the one that really spins his head. And look at that uppercut. There's the damaging blow. Now the legs go rubbery. Another vicious right hand. So it's two right uppercuts in a row that did the damage. Two vicious right uppercuts. They talk about his left hook. Here's Muhammad Ali again. Muhammad. They want you on national television again and around the world. How about that big fight coming up? Tell me about that fight.
I'm going to retire George Foreman. He's too slow. He can't hit me with this stuff. I'm a professional.
Turn around and face that camera over there, Ali. They want to hear about you and talk to you around the world.
He hit Ken Norton just like he do all his opponents. Caught him early. I mean, he is hard, but if a man can stay out of the way for 5 rounds, stick him, move, stay out of range, be in good shape, he'll retire George Foreman. This man depends on getting this man in the first 1 or 2 rounds. If he don't do that, he's frustrated. Stick him with left jabs and right crosses. tie him up and box him, and you will return.
No, Ali.
I'm the oldest man that's going to whoop George Foreman, and I'm going to whoop him of all places in Africa, in the Congo, where the Lumumba boys are.
No, Ali, now that you have your cool about you and you calm down at this point, I want you to answer this question. How could that man go 24 rounds with you and only two with the heavyweight champion of the world?
Because George Foreman is not as good of a fighter scientific as I am, but I admit he's stronger and he hit harder. I'm not a hard puncher. I'm not known for being a hard puncher. I fought many men like Floyd Patterson, Zora Foley, George Fowler, who are stronger than I am. Many I couldn't knock out, Sonny Liston. But I'll tell you this, boxing ability, speed, whooping him on points for the distance if necessary. Then I'll whoop him.
Well, fighting in your home territory, you couldn't be any happier the way this is coming up in September.
Why would you call Africa my home territory?
You've been telling me that for 10 years.
That's right, and if you come over there talking like that, we'll cook you.
That's it for Muhammad Ali. If I go over to the Congo, and I'll probably be there, I'm going to get cooked.